Welcome. My name is Mackenzie McCormick, and on behalf of the Health Information Technology team at the Healthcare Authority, we thank you for joining us for the Participating in the Clinical Data Repository webinar. This video is for provider organizations that are required to participate in clinical data submission to the CDR by February 1st, 2017. This video will help walk you through determining if you are required to submit, the preparation process with our technical partner, as well as resources available to you. The Link for Health Clinical Data Repository is a direct response by the Washington State Healthcare Authority to the interoperability challenges identified by the community. The CDR connects electronic health record platforms from different vendors and aggregates clinical information in one easily accessible location. By providing access to clinical information from outside the enterprise, the CDR helps the care team gain a more comprehensive understanding of the patient's health history. This enables clinicians to achieve better results for their patients and improve overall community health. Authorized users can view CDR data in two ways: initially through a clinical portal, and eventually they can import it from the CDR into their EHR system to view it using their standard workflow. If you meet all of the following criteria, you are required to submit clinical summary data in electronic format by the February 2017 deadline. Your organization is part of a managed care organization that serves Apple Health consumers. Your organization has an electronic health record system, and your organization's electronic health record system is 2014 certified. Please note, we do not have visibility into whether or not you are contracted with one or more of the managed care organizations. If you receive communications from Amerigroup, CHPW, Coordinated Care, Molina, or UHC, chances are you are contracted with them. If you do not receive communications but still aren't sure, please contact your leadership. If you aren't sure if your EHR is certified, please follow the link at the bottom of the slide. Now let's get started. OHP is the state-designated health information exchange and is the CDR vendor partner for the Healthcare Authority. So the first step is to visit OneHealthPort at www.onehealthport.com/HCA-CDR. Once you land on the CDR page, there will be four steps to help you prepare for your data submission and viewing in the CDR. If you're not already registered with the OneHealthPort Health Information Exchange, or HIE, we will go through steps 1 and 2 first. If you are already registered with the HIE, please refer to only steps 3 and 4. Please note that each step does take time to review, process, and complete. The time required to complete each step could vary substantially depending on your organization's contract management process, EHR vendor relationship, and how familiar you are with the clinical data exchange. In steps 1 and 2, there are a few things to take note of: the OneHealthPort CDR information, the readiness activity survey, and the HIE contract. In step 1, you will review the OneHealthPort CDR information, which includes details on consent, access, and data classification for use of the CDR. Please note that you are responsible for understanding and sharing this information with individuals from your organization that will use the CDR. In step 2, after reviewing OneHealthPort CDR information, you will take a readiness survey. The kind of questions you'll see on this survey are whether or not you have a certified EHR, your connection to others to share clinical documents, and your services to Medicaid patients. It will also gauge your capability to exchange clinical care summaries in a standard electronic format known as Consolidated Clinical Data Architecture, or CCDA. By completing this survey, this will measure how ready your organization is to start data submission to the CDR. By clicking Go to the Contracting page under Step 2, HIE Contracting, you will find another set of steps and requirements to complete your participation agreement through online contracting. Review the OneHealthPort HIE Participation Agreement. This document provides more detail on the pricing schedule, Secure Hub services, participation terms and conditions, business associate policy, OneHealthPort HIE user policy, and security policy. Also available to you is the One Healthport HIE Operating Manual, and another opportunity to determine your annual HIE subscription fee. The OHP subscription fee is on a sliding scale that depends on your annual net patient revenue. Please note, in Step 3, you are required to identify a person from your organization to obtain a One Healthport single sign-on subscriber ID and be assigned as an administrator to access online contracting. When you have successfully registered with the One Healthport HIE, you should then contact your electronic health record vendor so they can help prepare and test your electronic clinical care summary files. These are the CCDA files that you will submit to the CDR. To learn more, click on the CDR tab at the top of the page, then click on Prepare the CCDA. You will find the following documents useful to begin exchanging CCDAs. The CCDA Implementation Guide is available to share with your EHR vendor regarding CCDA specification information. One Healthport Object Identifiers is offered to learn more about the assigned identifiers and CCDA messages sent through the HIE. And CCDA validation testing instructions to prepare you for CCDA exchange testing. Once you have reviewed all of the documents and are ready to verify the CCDA data in the CDR, submit a One Healthport HIE support request form. You'll also submit the same form when testing is validated and you're ready for CCDA message submission through the production environment. If you experience difficulty with this step, your vendor is available to help you along the way. You can also request support from OHP at any time. After successfully submitting data into the CDR, you are required to contribute provider information to the One Healthport Provider Directory, which will populate to the CDR. To learn about the benefits of this directory, please select Read More about Electronic Provider Directory Reporting to find the implementation guide for electronic data submission titled One Healthport Provider Directory. To request access to the provider directory, you will go through the HIE application portal, but will need your One Healthport subscriber ID, a One Healthport HIE contract, and a CDR access role assigned by your administrator. For more videos, please visit our website resource pages. We have two pages, one for EHR resources and one for CDR resources. Remember to read all the information provided on the One Healthport page as you work towards meeting the February 1st, 2017 data submission requirement. If you have questions or need additional information, please submit a One Healthport HIE support request form, complete the fields, and select the support type you are seeking. For more information, please visit our website, or if you have general questions about the CDR, please email us at healthit@hca.wa.gov and put CDR in the subject line. A copy of this webinar will be available at the Health IT website. Thank you for participating, and we appreciate your partnership in this endeavor to improve the coordination of care within Washington.